السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا وطبيب نفوسنا حبيب إله العالمين أبي القاسم المصطفى محمد، وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين المنتجبين الذين أذهب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا. عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل. Once again, we thank Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us this opportunity on this beautiful Friday to continue to acquire the understanding of our faith and to seek nearness to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our brief discussion last week Friday was still on the first amongst men and women to accept Islam, when our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam was instructed by Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to proclaim and to announce his mission to the people. We got to a point when we're looking at some of the views as to who was the first to accept or embrace Islam. So there are few views, and we discussed them last week. One of them was that Imam Ali alayhi salam was young, and so the Islam of a young person cannot be accepted. Young in the sense that they said he wasn't matured, he was not baligh, so his Islam is not accepted in that way. But of course, from this book that we've been discussing, Al-Qisas Al-Qur'aniyya, he responded beautifully to those who are of the view that Imam was young, or it wasn't Imam, it was someone else. So let's look at the way and manner Ayatollah Makarim Shirazi responded to these claims from this book that we've been discussing, inshallah. He mentioned that, number one, illa anna awwalan, firstly, kama kulna, inna sinna aliyin alayhi salam, as-sagir fi dhalika al-yawm, la yakdahu fi ahamiyyat al-amr bi ayyi wajhin. It's like the way we said before, the age of Imam Ali alayhi salam will not affect that leadership, will not affect the fact that he was the first to accept when the Holy Prophet of Islam came with this message. وَلَا يُكَلِّلُ مِنْ شَأْنِ, that this will not reduce anything of value in regards to him accepting that Islam from the Holy Prophet. Then he said, خَاصَّةً وَأَنَّ الْقُرْآنَ الْكَرِيمَ كَالَ فِي شَأْنِ يَهْيَا. He said, especially, the Holy Quran mentioned and discussed about Prophet Yahya alayhi salam. And Allah says, وَآتَيْنَاهُ الْحُكْمَ صَبِيًّا. And this is chapter Maryam, verse 12. That we gave, or we brought the hukum to Yahya while Yahya was young, John the Baptist. Yahya was very young, and he was made prophet by Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in fact, if you compare with the age of Imam Ali, when he accepted Islam from the Holy Prophet, Imam was older than Yahya. وَكَذَلِكَ نَكْرَأُ مَا قَالَهُ فِي شَعْنِ عِيسَى عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ. And he said, Likewise, we read a verse of Quran in regards to Prophet Isa ala nabiyyina wa alihi wa sallam, that min annahu takallama wa huwa fil mahd, that Isa alayhi salam spoke while he was in a cradle. He was very young, he was infant when he spoke. Wa khataba ulaika alladhina waqa'u fi hiratin wa shakka min amrihi, and he addressed those who were confused about his affairs, about his miraculous birth, because they knew Maryam alayha salam to be modest, to be chaste woman. All of a sudden, Maryam is saying, I've got a son. And of course, Maryam, what she did, that you know very well, she indicated to Isa alayhi salam. And of course, Isa himself addressed them as to who he is. And you know very well this. I'm just going through the book to make sure that we are in the same wavelength. What did Isa say in chapter Maryam, verse 30? Inni Abdullah, atani al-kitaba wa ja'alani nabiyya. That I am the servant of Allah. He has given me book and made me prophet. And Isa was infant when he said that. So therefore, Ayatullah Makarim in this book is saying, إِنَّنَا إِذَا دَمَمْنَا مِثْلَ هَذِهِ الْآيَاتِ الْقُرْآنِيَّةِ إِلَى الْحَدِيثِ الَّذِي نَكَلْنَاهُ آنِفًا مِنْ أَنَّهُ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ وَصَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَآلِهِ جَعَلَ عَلِيًّا وَصِيَّهُ وَخَلِيفَتَهُ. He said, if we combine all these verses to the traditions we quoted earlier on, that the Holy Prophet of Islam made Ali his deputy and his vicegerent, اتدها أن هذا الكلام لم يصدر إلا أن تعصب المقيت. But those who are of the view that Ali alayhi salam was young, and as a result of that, we cannot accept his Islam at that age. He said that is just out of, you know, jealousy and out of discrimination and out of antagonism. Otherwise, Quran made it very clear. There were prophets who were way younger than Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam. Now let's go to the second response of Ayatullah Makarim in this book, Al-Qisas Al-Qur'aniyah. He said, "Inna min ghayri al-musallam tarikhiyan." He said, look, it is a known fact historically that there is no one mentioned who has accepted Islam before Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi afdalu salati wa azka salam. He was the one who accepted it. And he said, وَنَنْهِي هَذَا الْبَحَثِ بِذِكْرِ هَذَا الْمَطْلَبِ. He said, we conclude this discussion on the first to accept Islam by mentioning this, that وَأَنَّ عَلِيًّا أَشَارَ مِرَارًا وَتَكِرَارًا فِي خُتَبِهِ إِلَىٰ أَنَّهُ أَوَّلْ مَنْ أَسْلَمْ. That Imam Ali alayhi salam, on numerous occasions in his sermons, indicated that he was the first to accept this religion. وَأَوَّلُ مَنْ آمَنَ. And he was the first to believe in the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi. وَأَوَّلُ مَنْ صَلَّ مَعَ النَّبِي. That he was the first to pray behind the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. وَبَيَّنَ مَوْكِعَهُ مِنَ الْإِسْلَامِ وَهَذِي الْمَسْأَلَةِ كَدْ نُكِلَتْ أَنُوْ فِي كَثِيرٍ مِنَ الْكُتُبِ. And Amir al-Mu'minin alayhi salam, on numerous occasions, explained his contribution towards the religion of Islam. And this has been narrated in so many books without an iota of doubt. And he said, إِضَافَةً إِلَىٰ أَنَّ بْنَ أَبِي الْحَدِيدِ نَكَلَ عَنِ الْعَالِمِ الْمَعْرُوفِ. He said, in addition to that, Ibn Abi al-Hadid is a great scholar who compiled the commentary or wrote the commentary of Nahj al-Balagha. The book says, in addition to what we have just presented you with, Ibn Abi al-Hadid also reported from a known scholar by the name Abi Ja'far al-Iskafi al-Mu'tazili, from the Mu'tazilite theological school of thought. And al-Ba'ad yaqulun, that some are saying, if indeed there were those who were Muslims before Imam Ali alayhi salam, that has not been proven properly. You know, what we know is that the first who accepted Islam is Imam Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi afdal salati wa aska salam. So this is the conclusion of that topic, the first to accept Islam. Now the next chapter is the chapter of what? Indharul Akrabin, Hadithu Yawm al-Dar. It's the chapter discussing the admonishing and inviting the families, the close relatives to Islam. That is when Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala sent our beloved Prophet with this message. The first people he asked them to invite them to this deen were his close relatives. So this is what they call Indharul Akrabin. Admonition, those who are close to him. This is what we all know as Hadithu Yawm al-Dar. The conversation and the discussion of the day of the house, meaning it happened within the family. وفق لما ورد في التواريخ الإسلامية, based on what has been reported in Islamic history, أمر النبي في السنة الثالثة بدعوته الأقربين من عشيرته. The Holy Prophet of Islam was instructed by Allah تبارك وتعالى in the third year after he was sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to invite his close relatives, his close family members. لأن دعوته حتى ذلك الحين كانت مخفية أو سرية. Because before inviting his family members, his invitation and propagation was what is known as da'watun sirri makhfi. It was hidden and secret way of propagating the deen of Allah. In other words, he was paving the way and preparing the grounds before going out publicly. Wa kana alladhina dakhalu fil Islam adadan qalila. And those who entered Islam during that time, they were handful. They were few in number. لِذَلِكَ هِنَ نَزَلَتِ الْآيَةِ. And that is when the verse of glorious Quran was revealed. Which ayah? وَأَنذِرَ عَشِيرَتَكَ الْأَقْرَبِينَ. This is chapter Shu'ara, verse 214. When this ayah was revealed unto the Holy Prophet, that was the moment when the Holy Prophet began to speak and invite his close relative to this deed. But before then, it was hidden and secret way of propagation Islam, or propagating Islam. And another ayah, look at what Allah says, chapter Hijr, verse 94. فَصُدَّعَ بِمَا تُؤْمَرْ وَأَعْرِدَ عَنِ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. In addition to this ayah of وَأَنذِرْ عَشِيرَتَكَ الْأَقْرَبِينَ, Allah revealed unto the Holy Prophet, فَصْدَعْ بِمَا تُؤْمَرْ. Go ahead to announce and proclaim as per the instruction you receive, as per the order you receive. وَأَعْرِدَ عَنِ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. Ignore the polytheists. This is the time for you to propagate, for you to invite people to monotheism. So these two verses, Shu'ara 2:14 and Hijr 94, are the verses instructing our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to go publicly after 3 years, which is a period of da'watun sirri or da'watun makhfi, meaning hidden or secret propagation. Umira an-nabiyyu sallallahu alayhi wa alihi an yaj'ala da'watahu alaniyatan. The Holy Prophet was ordered and instructed, of course, by Allah to make his propagation public. In other words, to invite people. وَبَدَأَ ذَلِكَ بِدَعْوَةِ أَهْلِهِ وَأَقْرِبَائِهِ الله أكبر. And he began by inviting his family members and those close to him. And this is how we should all do. When you have something new, before you go about shouting and telling the whole world, first talk to your families. Yes, if you speak to them and they don't budge, it doesn't work out, then you go. First, you have to begin with your own family. You don't come and tell me I'm wrong, when in your own backyard, there are so many wrongs there. First, clean your backyard before you come to me. Yes, if you try cleaning your backyard and it's not happening, at least you've done your part, then you can come on my case. But if you look at what's happening today, people are offloading their anger on others, when in their own backyard, there are so many works that needs to be done in terms of cleansing. So the Holy Prophet began with his close relatives. And this is the instruction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَمَّا كَيْفِيَّةُ إِبْلَاغِهِ وَإِنْذَارِهِ إِيَّاهُمْ He said, now, let's look at the method that was adopted by our beloved Prophet when inviting his close relatives and family members. فَهُوَ بِإِجْمَالِ أَنَّهُ دَأَ النَّبِيُّ عَشِيرَتَهُ إِلَى بَيْتِ أَمِّهِ أَبِي طَالِبٍ This is how he did it. The Holy Prophet of Islam invited his close relatives to the house of his uncle, Abu Talib, salawatullahi wa salamahu alayhi. وَكَانُوا فِي ذَلِكَ الْيَوْمِ حَوَالِي 40 رَجُلًا He said, when he invited them to the house of Abu Talib, they were around 40 people. Around 40 there and there. They all came. وَكَانَ مِنْ مَنْ هَذَرَ هَذِهِ الدَّعْوَةِ بَعْدُ أَعْمَامِ النَّبِيِّ Amongst those who attended and responded to the invitation of Prophet to be at the house of Abu Talib were the uncles of the Holy Prophet. Who were the uncles? Ka'abi Talibin, of course, Abu Talib, Ridwanullahi Ta'ala Alayhi was there. Wal Hamza, Hamza, Salamullahi Alayhi, he was also there. Wa Abu Lahabin, Abu Lahab was also there. Wal Abbas, Abbas was also there. Wabada antana walu tu'ama after they enjoyed the food. Wa arada nabiyya an yu'addi ma alayhi. And then the Holy Prophet wanted then to inform them, of what he invited them for. Takallama Abu Lahab, Abu Lahab spoke kalimatin with some words which wasn't good. Ahbata biha khittat an-nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alihi. What he spoke, it was distraction. He disrupted what he spoke. Lidhalika aw lidha faqad da'ahum an-nabi fi al-yawm al-thani aw fi al-yawm al-tali aidan. Because of the disruption of Abu Lahab, the Holy Prophet on that first day, he did not proceed with the meeting. What he did, he adjourned it to the next day. He adjourned it to the next day. Inshallah, this is where we would like to invite brothers and sisters to pay attention, inshallah, because the next chapter we'll be doing will be the chapter about Abu Talib alayhi salam and the roles that Abu Talib played. So the first one is that this first meeting and gathering was at the house of Abu Talib, salamullahi alayhi. Now the next day when they came, وَبَعْدَ أَن تَنَاوَلُ الطَّعَامَ After they enjoyed the food, قَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَعَلِيهِ The Holy Prophet then said to them, يَا بَنِي عَبْدُ الْمُطَلِّبِ Oh, the family, the children, the progeny of Abd al-Muttalib. إِنِّي وَاللَّهِ مَا أَعْلَمُ شَابًا فِي الْعَرَبِ جَاءَ كَوْمَهُ بِأَفْضَلِ مِمَّا جِئْتُكُمْ بِخَيْرِ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ He said, Oh, my people, I do not know of any Shab, any youth in Arab, in Arabic Peninsula or in the Arab world, who went to his people with the best of dunya and akhirah. وَكَدَ أَمَرَنِيَ اللَّهُ أَنَّ أَدْعُوَكُمْ إِلَيْهِ. He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has instructed me and ordered me to invite you to the best for you in dunya and akhirah. Then he says, فَأَيُّكُمْ يُعَذِرُنِي عَلَىٰ أَمْرِ هَذَا. Who amongst you will support me, will assist me in this matter? Inshallah, we will continue with our class next week, inshallah. We pray to Allah Azza wa Jal to forgive us and make us his true slaves and servants. Mu'minin and mu'minat who are not well, may Allah cure them with his cure. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa salli allahumma ala muhammadin wa alihi tayyibin at-tahirin.